Do you live off grid at the moment, or are you, in fact, have you got a little electricity supply running from the house to your shed?
No, I have never had any electricity running at my house. I'm completely off the grid. At this exact moment, I am at a shared work. It's called Comerge. It's one of the shared offices where you can have an office without having to have an office. And so I'm here today. This is a good place to get stuff done, be able to do Skype interviews, things like that, because I don't have internet at my house or a phone. I'm completely unreachable at my house.
Cool. And do you have a toilet at your house?
Yeah, I have a little, this about as simple as it gets, a little 5 gallon composting toilet, and then I have my humanure compost bin. So, but yeah, no, I have rainwater harvesting, so that's all the water I have, and then just a couple of small solar panels. So it's pretty simple. I was gone for the last 2.5 months. I just got home 7 days ago, and it's good to be home.
I think that the solution that you found is a great one, and I'm surprised more people don't do it. How did you find this kind yard owner? Is he a friend of yours? Do you think there are many more people like that?
So I found him by, I just wrote a blog that said looking for a home for my tiny home, and I just posted it in local forums around San Diego and had some friends share it. And I had about a dozen people respond and say that I could set up my tiny home in their backyard. And the idea was simple, to provide a mutually beneficial relationship where I would improve the backyard, do their yard maintenance, grow food for them, build a rainwater harvesting system, build raised bed gardens. And then the idea is that I was just going to stay for a year or two. And then when I leave, all of it's theirs, the rainwater harvesting, the gardens, and all that. So I'm all about trying to find ways to do things without money. And secondly, use resources that are going to waste. This guy, was someone who responded online. He wasn't using his backyard. He actually dreamed of having something like this in his backyard. And so it's been a really great mutually beneficial relationship. And I would say there's hundreds of thousands, no, I would say there's millions of unused spaces around, just in the United States and England alone, there's millions. So around the world, there's millions and millions of these places. I would say if anyone wants a free place, offer something and then put yourself out there because there are so many open backyards that could be turned into a little sustainable homestead.
But I think you're rather remarkable, aren't you? Because you, you've made your whole life around giving and about not really caring about ownership, and that makes you pretty special and unusual, because most of us can't kind of get over the idea that our home is our home, and there's a feeling that there's a need of for permanence, a sense of being able to put down roots there. Most people who live in a house could live there 40 years, and yet you have the agility, the mental agility to not feel like that. But most people do feel, that a home has to be forever.
Yeah, I totally understand that. I've had that feeling inside me at times, but for me, the way I look at it is when the earth is your home, you could never be homeless. And now, that doesn't mean that homeless people that have no home, I'm not saying that everything's perfect for them, but what I'm saying is that when you have the mindset that the earth is your home and that it can provide for you, then you're always at home. And that's the way that I look at it.
Okay, so if you want to be like Rob Greenfield, folks, step one, change your mental attitude. Complete.
It's all a matter of perspective. Change your perspective and you change your world. That's what it's all about.
So, and step two, find a philanthropic or unconventional person who's prepared to let a relative stranger live in their backyard. Tolerant guy, but you said there's a fair exchange. How has it been? Has there been any little practical problems that you weren't expecting about, having friends over late at night or anything like that?
No, he's a really nice guy, and he's in Hawaii a lot, and I'm gone a lot, and so we haven't stepped on each other's toes in any way. There is honestly an element of me somewhat feeling like, you know, the place where I feel like I'm a visitor in my own home sometimes. Like I tend to be kind of a little quiet sometimes, but the fact is that everything's been going really good. I would say that the situation that I have is not a perfect situation in the sense that I do feel somewhat out of place sometimes.
Well, it's good to admit that to yourself, yeah. And then you can do something about it, I guess.
And you said step two of how to do it, but the truth is it's all about using the resources that you have around you and adapting it into your situation. So if it's about living off the grid in particular, or if it's just about like cutting back drastically on the amount of money you need in your life or just simplifying, my suggestion is don't try to be like me. Instead, take what you can from my example and adapt that into your lifestyle, and take what you can from other people who you agree with or respect or admire, and then adapt that into your life. But it's nothing is a one-size-fits-all solution. Every country around the world, every little plot of land has its own way that things work.
Absolutely. And equally, it's not a race. This isn't about being the most off-grid person in the world or the most ethical person in the world. It's about doing what you can and, above all, sort of feeling comfortable in your own skin.